close with this. If you're not saved, really it all boils down to one thing. There's something that you think is bigger or more important than serving God. Could be the most innocent of things. It could be that you think, I'm going to wait till I get on my deathbed and I'll get saved then. Why would someone do that? Because they worship control of their life more than giving God control. But the only problem with that is half the people that die with their shoes on. Unexpectedly. Heart attack, stroke. They're gone. Automobile accident. An accident at work. They're here today. They're gone just that quick. Not everybody lays in the bed and suffers and dies. What is it that you're putting before God? If you're not saved, it is because there is something in your life that is bigger to you than God. You didn't mean for it to be that way. I guess probably the number one thing I find with the good people I deal with is they just feel like their past is too big. They've gone too far. They've waited too late. But I got news for you. God was there when you committed every sin you ever committed. He loved you then, and bless God, He loves you now.
Amen.
He will save your soul. I'm sorry that you put Him off, and I'm sorry that you waited so long. But you can be saved now, young person. He'll tell you, don't you hate what the devil does? When you're young, you'll say, wait. You got plenty of time. Put it off. Wait. Then when you get old, you get a family, the devil will say, you're too busy right now. You don't have time. Well, how in the world are you going to get saved and go to church? You don't have time to cut your grass and wash your car. How are you going to make time for church? I'm telling you, this is the way the devil works. And then when you get older, you get sick, or your body starts getting weak, the devil will say, come to God now. Because you're sick. The fellow told me one time, said, I can't come to the Lord now, preacher. I'm sick. I said, why not? I couldn't think of a better time to come to Him. If you need Him more now than you ever needed it.
Amen.
But God was there through every bit of it. Let me tell you, there's only one reason that you're even alive and here tonight. Because the true and the living God loves you enough.
Amen.
To give you one more chance to repent of your sin and ask Jesus to come into your heart. Whatever it is that keeps you from coming to the Lord, do you think it's really worth missing heaven for? I don't think it is. Let's stand together. Come get a song of singers, if you will. And as they're coming, we appreciate so much what you're doing. Thank God. Your heads are bowed for a moment. Let me ask something. If you died right now, do you know you'd go to heaven? If you don't know, you'd go to heaven. If there's something that has taken place in your life that has put God on the back burner, every head is bowed and no one's looking on, and you need prayer, would you just raise your hand right now and say, preacher, that's me. And I know this isn't the answer, but it's a good place to start. I need prayer. I want you to pray for me. How many of you just raise your hand right now? Say, please pray for me. Would you do that? God bless you. God bless your heart. Somebody else. Just slip your hand up too. Pray for me. Pray for me. Hey, sis, why don't you just go ahead and come on out of your seat right now, even before they sing. Come right on. I'm telling you, you could be the key to break this whole revival open. If you're inside the aisle there, just in the pew, just take one step. They'll let you out, and your friends can come with you. And there'll be people to meet you here and pray with you. You come right on. Would you do that? Come on, right now. Come on, do more than raise your hand. Come and give your heart to God. Just come right on. If you want to pray, just come on. Come on. There is nothing worth missing heaven for. And you'll find out every time you say no, it'll get easier to say no the next time. So what you ought to do right now, just come. We're not asking you to come and join this church. We're not asking you to do the impossible. We're asking you to come and look to the Lord and let Him come into your life. Would you come right now? I'm telling you, Jesus misses you. And He wants you to come. So why don't you just move right on out of your seat and don't wait and just say right now, I'm going to talk to the Lord. Would you do that? Go ahead and sing, folks, as you sing. Why don't you come? Why don't you come? Whether you raised your hand or not, come right on out of your seat. Let's pray. Will you do it? Will you do it? Come on. Come on. Will you come? That's the truth.
You need to come.
Will you come?